From January to August 2013, as many as 126 extrajudicial deaths and over 400 disappearances took place in Balochistan province, Pakistan. Violent killings and disappearance after arrest by state authorities continues relentlessly. Most of the bodies of the victims of extrajudicial killings have been found in the Balochi-speaking districts of the province, particularly Quetta, Khuzdar, Kalat, and Mekran. Balochistan has remained under the control of the military and other allied security agencies since the Musharraf regime began military operations there in 2000. A constant stream of disappearances of activists and youth was thereby introduced.
Actually, the Balochi people, those who are living in Balochistan, they think that Pakistan has occupied their land, because it was not part of the Pakistan. But exactly after some months of creation of Pakistan, then Pakistani forces went over to Balochistan and captured that. And since that time, there is an insurgency in the Balochistan. And people think that they are denied of their basic rights. So, since then a strong reaction started from the Pakistani forces. First, they started killing the people or threatened the tribal leaders and Balochi people and said that this is the part of the Pakistan. This is the largest province, but it has only a small population, the lowest one population in compare with the other provinces. They were also demanding that they have the right on their resources, so that then the people wanted their autonomy on the natural resources, but the military denied that and they started the action against the Balochis. So, when there was a first military government in the Pakistan, so the general of that time, Field Marshal Ayub Khan, he promised the Baloch leaders that you surrender your arms, we will just give you amnesty. As they surrendered, the Pakistan military has arrested all of them and hanged them, and then betrayed that promise. Since 1960, this movement of Balochistan started in a way of armed struggle. Then again, when there was a civilian government in 1973 of Bhutto, then Bhutto also launched a military action against the Balochi people. And again, during this Musharraf government, a new process has been introduced in the Pakistan, that was the disappearances and extrajudicial killings. And there was one case of a rape of a lady doctor by a major, but the General Musharraf, then the ruler of the Pakistan, he supported the major in the case of rape. And the Balochi people saw that how military is ruthless in dealing with the people, not even punishing a major, ordinary major. So then again it started for that some other areas, so that is a very long history. But the government started detaining the people, particularly the intelligence agencies, the military and the frontier corps. The frontier corps is actually a wing of the army. Serving generals are heading that army. So they started. And when there was the Zardari government, then a new phenomena, the frontier corps started. That was the extrajudicial killing. That to eliminate the evidence of disappearances. So now this is continued, and since 2010 up to now, more than 500 persons are extrajudicially killed in Balochistan. And during this year, we have the HRC has documented cases that 127 persons were extrajudicially killed and more than 400 were disappeared. So this is a background of that Balochistan situation of disappearances.
The disappearances and extrajudicial killings have not stopped even after the formation of the government of Dr. Abdul Malik, who also heads the Baloch ethnic political party.
as I have mentioned you, it is ruled by the military. So there was no intention to solve the issue of Balochistan, as our military did in the former East Pakistan, which is now Bangladesh, that they started solving the political issue with the force and military action. So the same method is being applied, because military cannot think beyond the militaristic mentality. This is not the war of getting the land, as the military always think that in the case of Bangladesh, they were thinking that we can have the land. They were not concerning about the human beings. The same thing is there. They only think in the form of land, not the human being. So how many are killed, disappeared, that is no worry about them.
The family members of disappeared persons have stated that the missing persons were arrested by the security forces, particularly by the Frontier Corps, and by the policemen accompanying this corps. Most of the dead bodies are of Baloch political workers. Despite appeals by international agencies and the families of victims, nothing has been initiated to either curtail the disappearances or recover the victims.
Families are struggling, and you can see that in many cases, that in many families, that more than one person was disappeared and extrajudicially killed, because military and the Frontier Corps or the forces of Pakistan or intelligence agencies, they don't spare these people. So people are always on the streets. They are demonstrating, protesting, documenting the cases, sending to the international forums and the international human rights organization. They also approached the Supreme Court of Pakistan, and Supreme Court of Pakistan has taken these cases of disappearances in Balochistan and the situation of Balochistan in 2005 or 2006. That was the main cause of removal of our Chief Justice, and who was restored by the people. But now again, the Supreme Court is only just threatening the military. Supreme Court knows that these people are with the military, and it says during its rulings that the people are with the military, with the intelligence agencies. Pakistan, we have documented that Pakistan has military is running 57 torture cells in the Pakistan in different cantonment areas. So in their cantonment areas, they are running torture cells, and the same thing with the Pakistan Air Force and Pakistan Navy. And these are besides the 1300 police torture centers in the country. So this country is whole a torture camp for the people.
In view of this apparent lack of action by judicial and government authorities, family members of the disappeared, brutalized, and murdered have lost all confidence in the institutions of justice.